Just the other day, a friend of mine called me up. A friend I hadn't spoken to in a while. And so, you know, we did the whole small talk thing. Until eventually the conversation turned to something deeper. We started to talk about religion. Now my friend, he is a full-on follower of Jesus, 100%. But he began to tell me that there are times, there are moments, where he feels out of place, even unwelcome, in his own church. Now, to be fair, the church that he belongs to is a great place. I've been there. It's full of wonderful people, and my friend would agree. But I can understand what he's talking about. He's a single guy in a sea of married people. He's more top 40 in a world of talk radio. And when it comes to politics, almost everyone around him is a Republican, and he's the other one. In a very put-together church, he's a guy who is still figuring stuff out. You know what I mean? Now, I know, not that big of a deal, but I can understand where the guy's coming from. There are times where he feels like he just doesn't fit their mold of what it means to be a Christian, you know? Now, some might say, find another church. Find a family that's a better fit. Go to a place where everybody's just like you. And maybe that's what he needs to do. Maybe. But I wonder. In the earliest days of Christianity, followers of Jesus were wrestling with some similar questions. You see, when Christianity first got rolling, it was a faith made up almost exclusively of men and women who had been born into Judaism. Now, first century Judaism was not just a religion. It was a heritage. It was a lifestyle. It was an identity. And to be a Jew prior to the arrival of Jesus was to be a part of a very special family. A special family that was set aside by God to send a message to the rest of the world. A message that someday God would send a Savior that would rescue everyone from sin and death. And so God gave that family certain rules and laws. He gave them a certain way of living that served to remind them of their purpose and the rest of the world of His plan. The only problem was when that Savior finally appeared, many people struggled leaving that special life behind. The book of Acts in the New Testament tells us that as a result, some of the non-Jewish Christians were beginning to feel as if they were less than the rest. Not only that, but some of the disciples who had set aside those rules and customs in order to introduce outsiders to the message of Jesus were being criticized. The new guys don't look like us. They don't act like us. They don't know the rules and laws, the secret handshakes and the inside jokes. You know what I mean? I guess you could say they didn't fit the mold. And so the early church was faced with a big question. Does everybody have to become like us in order to be welcomed into this family? Or are we going to become a family that welcomes everybody? That's a great question to ask. I mean, think about my friend's church. Think of our church. Are we okay if some of us are different? Are we okay if some people have a different background? Are we okay if there are only some who have their lives put together and others are still a great big mess? Or do we prefer that everyone come pretty cleaned up, that they vote a certain ticket, and that they look a lot like us in order to feel comfortable in our community? That's a tough question to answer. Until you look at Jesus. Now, when most people think of Jesus, they think of the miracles He did. You know, changing water into wine, healing the sick, raising the dead. But I love what one of my favorite authors says. He writes that one of the most supernatural things Jesus ever did is something that often gets overlooked. He never showed favoritism. Ever. Now, don't get me wrong. Jesus called out sin when He saw it, and He spoke the truth in love. But Jesus always welcomed. Jesus always loved. And He always shared His message with everyone. But He never played favorites. And He never showed partiality, which is something every human does. I mean, think about it. Your mom always said that she loved you and your brothers equally, but you know that you were the favorite. But things were different with Jesus. With Him, everybody had access. Everybody. And when it comes to life as his church, God wants us to try and live the same way. That's what the early church discovered. One disciple in particular, named Peter, struggled greatly with this. Until finally he said to the other followers of Jesus, "Look, I know that everybody else might be very different than us, but I also know that they have received the same gift as us, the Spirit of God and faith in Jesus. And that is the only thing that matters. And that is what we have in common. And every other barrier must be broken down." You see, when it comes to the church, when it comes to being God's family here on earth, what connects us together is not common interests or a similar income. It's not age or race, politics, or even tradition. No. What brings us together, what binds us together, is a common experience. A common experience of being forgiven through Jesus' death on the cross and filled with His Spirit at our baptism. That's what matters most. That's the mold. That's what we have in common. Everybody has access to Jesus. And you see, that's what's so beautiful about this faith. At the foot of the cross, day laborer and million-dollar executive, the healed and the hurting, the sinner and the... well, that one's everybody. At the foot of the cross, everyone is the same. And we are one. We're all saved by grace. I'll admit, I didn't have any sage advice to offer my friend. I didn't quite know what to say, but I can understand how he feels. Some people might say he needs to find a different church, one that's a better fit. More importantly, I think he just needs to be reminded. I think we all just need to be reminded of what it is that makes us a church. May we be a family that loves, a family that welcomes. May we be a family that shares the message of Jesus with everybody. May we be a community marked not just by a common appearance on the outside, but a common faith on the inside.